Yo, what is up, guys? Welcome back to another video here on Loud and Proud. Hopefully you guys are doing absolutely fantastic. I actually just ended my video from 2 days ago, a little bit ago. So I'm going to be following off from that video and we're going to be continuing on the second gen Longhorn project. This truck needs a new front bumper. Once we get everything put on, we're trying to rush the truck over to paint and body to get it dropped off before the holidays so that the guy can have the truck to start doing some stuff on it so he can get a move on the truck with the project and just get going on it. Like I've told you guys in the previous videos, I'm thinking about going with the original maroon color so that he doesn't have to do all the door jams and all the other stuff. All he's gonna have to do really is under the hood and the hinges for the hood because they're a different red color. And then he's just gonna fix like a dent here and then there's a little bit of rust on the cab. And then other than that though, pretty much the only real like dent repair, I guess you could say, and stuff that he has to really deal with is the bed. The bed is what needs most of the work. Hopefully that can all work out and it can all get done in a timely manner. He said it'll probably take him approximately 2 to 4 weeks depending on how much there is to do because he hasn't seen the truck yet. But I told him for the most part, the cab is pretty straight, but the bed is what needs some work. And you know, just a little bit of rust on the doors on the truck and a couple little dents here and there, but nothing too major. He's like, I can definitely do it. It's just a matter of how long it'll take based on how much it actually is when he sees it. Let's get to taking the bumpers here and putting them on the truck and all that jazz. But if you have not done so yet, you only have one more day to get 5 entries for every $5 you spend. Information is in the description below if you want to win our 2017 F-250 Platinum or our 1996 we call Frosty. I don't have them here with me right now because they're both getting some work done, but if you go to the website lmpgear.com, information is in the description below on how to enter and all that stuff. There are pictures of the trucks on the websites, what's done to them, stuff like that, so you guys can look at the trucks you are going to be winning. So you're probably wondering what front bumper we got for this truck, and some of you are going to love it, some of you are going to not love it yet, at least not yet. So let me just show you. It's a fourth gen bumper, but it's not a big chrome fourth gen bumper. It's a black paintable fourth gen bumper with the valance and everything. Let me just explain why. I know there's gonna be some people that are like, dude, go off-road bumper, this, that, and the other, and I wanted to. Just so you know, I did look for a long time for an off-road bumper, and they were either A, just extremely hard to find, or B, extremely expensive. And I understand they're more expensive. Like for a good off-road bumper, you're gonna pay over a grand easy, sometimes two. But I was like, dude, like I'd rather put some money into the truck in other areas than a freaking bumper like that. Like, holy crap. So I'm like looking and looking and looking. They're just super expensive. So I decided to go this route. It is a paintable front bumper and it's going to be paint matched to the entire truck itself. It's not just gonna be like, nothing against this truck, because this truck is awesome, but it's not just gonna be like a super nice, clean, everything's color matched, the mirrors and handles and all this stuff, and then a big chrome bumper on it. So for this truck, this is what I went with. It's okay, don't hate, just trust the process and wait until it's done, because you guys are gonna really like it. Trust me, you're gonna love it. But I think this is just like the right move for what we're doing with this truck. Let's get these brackets put on, which are also the fourth gen conversion brackets. That one's actually pretty marred up right there. But anyways, hopefully these work. I got these on eBay. There's tons of them now. There's all kinds of companies that make them anymore. It's not just like you have to get them from one place. But so we're gonna get these brackets. We're going to put them on here, get the bumper mounted up to the truck. And then I need to figure out what kind of seat I'm gonna put in the truck in the meantime so I can drive the truck around to get it even to get the bed on and to get the paint body work done and then get it back at whatever seat I put in the truck, whether it's a seat from Rosine or my dad's other truck. It might be my dad's other truck because, you know, he doesn't really gotta drive it much. It's gonna be in there for 3 to 4 weeks, and that's why I'm trying to really think about which seat I'm gonna take out to get in there. Let's get to putting the mounting brackets on this bumper and getting this thing bolted up to the truck. So the front bumper is on the truck, and let me just explain a couple of quick things because I already know there's some people scrolling down in the comments. So let me just comment something really quick. First off, let me explain the gap right here before everybody freaks out. First thing I'm trying to explain is A, the guy that's going to be doing the paint work has to be able to get the headlights out, and the bumper does fit tight all the way up to the fender, but I didn't want to do that because then that would make it a pain in the butt for him. Not to mention, once he does get them out, he has to be able to paint this whole bumper. And I don't want this to be so tight that he can't get in here and do his work. Also, same on the other side. I left the same size gap on this side with the bumper for the exact same reason. I wanted him to be able to get to this 10 millimeter right here, pop it out to take the headlights out, But in terms of adjusting the bumper, it's literally just a matter of loosening the bolts and then pulling it up, and then it'll seal that gap off. But just so nobody freaks out and goes, oh my gosh, there's a bumper gap. It's like, okay, well, it's also missing a hood and a bed and rear bumper and tons of other stuff. That shouldn't be the number one concern right now, but I really just wanted to get this thing on the truck so that he could paint it all as one piece and get it done. But in terms of this spacing right here, it will be solved. And you also have to take this into consideration in the first place. Do you realize that second gen bumpers have a much bigger gap because you're able to fit an entire wrench in there easily and take the headlights off versus even this? This isn't even much gap, but it's already just enough to where, unless you have like a real small, short 10 millimeter, it just hardly fits on that. And of course, I'm not worried about scratching it because he's gonna have to sand and paint and all that stuff on here as it is. But let me just show you actually for comparison on Nasty Red. Okay, so here's Nasty Red's front bumper. And as you can see, literally I can stick my entire hand in between the bumper. And I don't know if you guys have ever noticed that, but pretty much every second gen bumper from the factory looks exactly like that. So it actually kind of makes me laugh when people are like, oh my gosh, you gotta make sure there's no gap anywhere. It's like, if you've ever seen a factory bumper, there's a massive gap all the way around it. Back in the shop here with this bumper on the truck, and as you can see, the gap, even this little gap, I cannot get my hand in between there like I could with the bumper on Nasty Red. And you know, you can see Rosine's bumper there is sealed all tight. He can get the paint work done, and we can get the new headlights in, and then we can adjust it if we want it to be permanent. Okay, so of course things are taking longer than I anticipate, which is a pretty standard thing it seems like. So I forgot when I said we're gonna go get the bed, I needed to put a seat in here because it's gonna be kind of hard to drive a 5-speed with no chair. So I took one out of Nasty Red and I'm hoping it fits. I don't know if the fitment is different from extended cabs or regular cabs, so we're about to find out. I know the bolts in terms of the placement are the same. I don't know if the bracket height is any different. So I'm gonna set my tripod up on the other side and see if we can get this seat set in here.
Let's see if it fits.
You got one bolt to line up, two bolts to line up. Oh, dang it. We're gonna try to make it work, but no guarantees. Three out of the four bolts should line up.
The seat did fit in the truck.
Not factory, because that was a power seat from an extended cab 12 valve. The seat is solid enough to do at least what we need to do, which is to get it from one place to get it to the next place and get it back here. So pretty much the seat's mostly just gonna be sitting in a shop while it's getting paint, but it just needs something in it to be able to actually drive the truck. Man, I just don't like that rusty seat in there from Nasty Red. I mean, there's like rust crumbling all over in the new carpet in there and all that jazz. And then also the Ford dealership did call me and they just said that the Platinum is ready to be picked up. So we're gonna go pick that up right now. We're not gonna be able to get the bed on today because we have an appointment in like the next 45 minutes. So I'm gonna have to pick up the Platinum, get back, and then that's pretty much, it's gonna be pitch black out. I'm not gonna be able to do any more of that stuff because that's gonna be outside. So anyways guys, let's get over to picking up that Platinum and seeing if that tailgate works again. Didn't get the bed on today due to having some other complications like, you know, being dark and running out of time. But we did get the tailgate fixed on the Ford. Check this out. Yeah, a tailgate that actually drops, who would have thought? So we did actually have to go pick these tires back up from the wheel and tire shop, and I'll tell you why. So when I ordered these tires, I didn't really think anything of it, but the wheels that were on the Dodge, the Frosty, not the Frosty, Frosty, they were 16 and a half inch rims. Those are 16 inch tires in terms of rim size. So it's not gonna work. So the wheels for Frosty are 16 and a half inch rims. If you guys are interested, those are gonna be for sale. And then in terms of the Ford's OEM wheels, the Platinum's wheels that came on the truck, I will be selling those as well. Those are gonna be for sale on Marketplace. Anyways, in terms of the tires though, we're gonna unload them. And I did order some new wheels for them though. Some 16 by 10 8-on-6.5 Pro Comp alloy wheels. They look just like the Mickey Thompson Classic 3s. They actually look just like the ones that came off this truck, just a different brand. But the Pro Comps are what we're going with. So I got those ordered. They're on the way. They should be here within the next, I don't know, couple days. And then we will see those once they are finished. So thank you for your patience. But anyway, so I'm gonna unload this stuff. Anyhow, guys, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Do not forget, you could be winning this truck that has a working tailgate, this 2017 F-250 Platinum, or my 1996 12 valve, 5-speed, 4-wheel drive, I call Frosty, the big white 12 valve. Anyways, guys, if you want to enter, information is in the description below. Those 5 entries for $5 deal is running out, so take us up on that while you can, and the giveaway is ending in about a week. Thank you guys so much. Subscribe if you're new. Leave a fat thumbs up. I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.